Hello guys, welcome to another Few Money. Today's Tuesday. Bitcoin has been falling since yesterday again, and people are just screaming and tearing their hair apart, just like crazy. For me, it's a good opportunity to buy the dip again. So I don't imagine, so many good news coming from South America and Central America. I don't understand why people are so afraid of the price action right now. We are still in a bull market, and I will show you guys just a bit later when we check the charts. But first of all, if you enjoy the content, gently touch the like button and subscribe to the channel if you are new. And let's go directly to screen share and check the charts. Okay, here we are, the price to time model, and I'm going to zoom in. We are just on top of 2017 cycle. The 20-week SMA is continuing this downtrend a bit. It's normal, we are below it. So it's been a few hard weeks for everyone, especially if you bought the top. But the majority of people have bought below the price level that we currently are in. So I don't see many reasons to be worried. I just would like people to have some cash on the side to start buying this dip soon, because I believe that the bottom will be in very soon, and this will always be a laggy, a lag statement, because you can only say it after you see the market going up back up again. But anyway, that's my belief. According to my analysis on the charts, that the bottom is really close. So let's see how this evolves. As comparing to the 2017 cycle and the 2013 cycle, we are still ahead. So this means that we still have some room to cross the 2017 cycle to the right and continuing this move up, which would be a kind of a delay comparing to the 2017 cycle. But I don't see any problem with that, and to be totally honest, this is what I think will happen. We will just continue to accumulate during some time here, and most probably we will have a reactivation of the price action to the upside very soon. So I'm not excluding the possibility that we could see lower lows, guys, compared to the 30,000 that we saw back here. But sorry for that. That I will give it only 20% probabilities that we would go lower than the 29,600 that we saw during this week. So we are still on the 80% probabilities of finding a bottom around the same level and reactivating the price action to the upside. So let's see. Let's continue to watch the charts and see what happens. The RSI doesn't look very good. So as you guys know, we were about to touch the orange dashed line again, but now we turn back down because of this drop since yesterday. So the RSI has no good news, and that's everything we can say about it. So let's check the charts on the MRI. Let me check the weekly. So on the weekly, we started this week on the green, and this was and still is an MRI bottom. We have the green arrow, although this big drop that we had since the beginning of the week is not a good sign. We are still in line with the support that we have around here, around the 28,000 to 30,000. So this has still not been broken. The only thing that was broken was this triangle here that we will see on the daily chart. But however, we are still on a 9 red of a 1-to-9 count. So this is an MRI bottom. It's still possible that during this week we could go back up and continue the trend, but we have to wait. In any case, I see the 50 period SMA coming back up. We are now, the 50 period SMA is now around the 29,300. Yeah, so 29,300. And this will act as support again, because we have this big support area around here, 28,000 to 30,000, which was the support of the price during the month of January when we had this big retracement. So far, we are still not in you know, I cannot call this a bear market, and I cannot even say that this is a very, very serious situation. So we are still holding the price action here, and I see a lot of weak hands being getting out of the market, and that's a very good sign too, because the you know, if you don't have so many weak hands, then the market can only go one way, and that's that's my analysis for the weekly chart. The RSI continues to go sideways, of course. No big deal here. The MACD continues bearish, so nothing else to check on the weekly. Let's take a look at the daily. So the daily has broken out to the downside of this triangle here, the symmetrical triangle. We are having a lot of extensions. This is the B extension. We have an A extension also on the MRI. This is very, very, very close to a bottom, guys. I can look at the charts and I see that very, very hardly we can go. It's very hard to go below, well, 20%. It's not so hard, but anyway, it's still hard to go below the 29,600 that we were already. But if that happens, I bet 100% of the weak hands will leave the market and then just leave the rest for the guys that are holding and completely aware that this is still a bull market. And if anyone else tells you the opposite, that this is a bear market, they just don't know what they are talking about. And I will show you guys why. Okay, so this is the daily. We are now on a 5 count of 9. I don't believe that we are going much more unless we have really short candles to get to a 9 on the daily, and that would take us to the end of the week. But I believe that during this week we can still see a small reactivation for the short term at least, and see some upwards price action. Let's see how this evolves. The RSI continues to go down on the daily, but we are not in oversold territory yet, so let's see. The MACD continues bullish on the daily. Also, the green bars are there, but we are declining, so the bearish momentum has been losing some strength. But the blue line is still above the orange, so it's not so bad as some people say it out there. Let's see the 4-hour, and then we can check the BitMEX funding rate, which is now very, very close to zero. Again, not really important to discuss. So on the 4 hours, we had this drop since yesterday, and during the entire night, this has been falling, but we are now sustaining the price around the 32K. So this was the lowest of the lowest tip here, 32K. And we are still holding the 28 to 30K support level, which is very, very strong. On the 4-hour, we are on oversold territory, and the MACD, of course, bearish. But however, there is a light red bar showing some signs of hope here. So let's see if in the short term we can see at least a small reactivation of the price action to the upside. Then that's it. There's no point checking the 1 hour because there's no BitMEX funding rate to discuss. So let me just go to the Pro Indicators framework. And here we are. I wanted to show you guys the daily because I think this is an important thing to continue my argument that we are still in a bull market, even with all those clickbait trolls and very famous YouTubers out there saying that this is a bear market already. I would like you guys to just look at this this ranging channel here, the trend channel that we have here on the daily, on the Pro Indicators. And this is something that I was usually hiding from the charts because it's a very, very big time frame, or you know, the interval for the time for this trend channel is very big. So I was looking at the more localized charts, always the 4 hour, to find the ranges for the one range boundary to the second, to the third and fourth. And now on the daily, I decided to show you guys something I had here for some time already. This is my trend channel since we started to break out in October 2020. And these two tops that we have here are exactly what makes the trend channel go parallel with that fourth range boundary there of the 4 hour chart. However, this is a daily chart. So this fourth range boundary here is from the time frame of the 4 hours and not a daily. However, so on the daily, this would be a second range boundary. if you count from that high, all-time high over there and the big drop we had. So this would be a second range boundary. However, this is from the other chart, and that's why it says fourth range boundary. But this would be a second, and so far we have been trading inside this big trend channel since we had the breakout in October last year, and this was the all-time high here. So to me, as long as we continue inside this trend channel, we are still in a bull market, and don't let anyone else tell you the opposite, because it's not true. Also, if you check the chart that we have right here that I've been using also with the two big movements of this bull cycle, you can see that we are still on the line and not breaking to the downside. So this line that starts with the, you know, COVID crash of March 2020 and touches the moment where we start to have the exponential bull cycle here and continues to the upside. And then for some magical reason, technical analysis worked, and this was plotted before the big drop happened. So the big drop happened to stop exactly on that trend line over there, which is a trend line of a bull cycle. This is a trend line of a bull cycle because it's pointing up, not down. And you can see, if you zoom in, that we still have the price action exactly on top of that trend line of the bull cycle. Even if you go below it, it's still possible that we can have a V-shaped recovery and go above that trend line again and continue to the upside in a more steady and sustainable pace up, going up. But it would be, of course, it would be very nice if we could hold this trend line and continue to the upside without crossing it to the downside. So on the daily, this is the chart I usually use for the daily to check the MACD. Also, the MACD has been turning down again. So again, sorry, for the first time since we touched the historic level of negative 5,100. So here it is. The blue line is for the first time turning a bit back down, but this corresponds to the drop that we had last night. So no big deal there. We are still above the orange line on the daily, and we still have the green bars, although they are becoming light green. But to me, it's not a very big deal as long as we continue the trend to the upside. And even if this trend fails, you can still extend this trend here, the first trend line of the start of the bull cycle, which started exactly at the lowest of 2018. You can still extend it to the right and still continue to go up on this trend line, although it would be much slower pace, a much slower pace to the top. Of course, we would have to wait a long time to reach a new top. So, but in any case, this is still a bull market. So this chart is analyzed. Let me just go back to the Pro Indicators here and show you guys that this trend channel is still valid. We did not cross it to the downside. And I will zoom in. You'll see here that the trend channel touches exactly the second range boundary of the daily, or the fourth range boundary of the 4-hour chart. And this new price action coming to the downside still did not cross the range, the trend channel to the downside. So this is still a bull market. Let's see if this continues to be the case, of course. But so far, all the technicals tell me that this is still a retracement of a bull market, and we are still on track to continue inside that trend channel. So that's it. Let me just very, very quickly check the dollar. So the dollar is on an MRI bottom, again, above the 90 on the Dixie, which I don't like, of course. You guys know that I've been expecting this support here to be broken. So nothing else to tell about the dollar. You've seen it many times in my videos. Gold is still fighting for this position, although we had an MRI top. Gold is being strong here on this price action and not going to the downside. So it's holding the line since yesterday at exactly the same level. The S&P 500 is looking for a new all-time high, but not being able to cross that resistance over there, that MRI top that we also had a few weeks ago. And so this is exactly the same as yesterday. No big news here. And the last chart, of course, is the one that we saw already. So I hope you enjoyed the analysis for today. I'm trying to keep the videos around 15 minutes so that everyone likes it better, because it's easier to watch a shorter video. So in any case, I just wanted to give you guys an update on the situation. I still believe that if we can hold this trend line here, and if we don't get out of the trend channel that I showed you on the Pro Indicators framework, this is still a bull market, and we have very good chances to go to the upside soon after some consolidation. So, by the way, the triangle that was broken to the downside, which I can show you guys again. So this is the tip of the triangle, but I can show you on the show you guys this on the daily chart. So this is a triangle that we have been looking a lot. Of course, this triangle does not correspond. This triangle was plotted based only on the biggest drop we had here, that second data point there to start the line, and the other one here. And then it got broken to the downside. But this triangle does not correspond to this one, because the bottom part of this triangle here was exactly the trend line that I plotted since the COVID crash of March 2020 and touching this area here, which was the start of the exponential bull market that we are seeing right now. So this is the bottom part of this triangle does not correspond exactly to the same triangle that we are seeing on the MRI charts. And this one still has not been broken to the downside, because as I said, this is the trend line that we have since a long time ago, since March 2020. So let's keep our fingers crossed and hope that this does not break to the downside. If it does, we will have to reevaluate the situation. Okay, stopping screen share now. So guys, I hope you enjoyed the content as usual. As usual, I would like you guys to gently touch the like button. Comment below, please. Leave your comments and tell me what you think about the analysis, if you agree, if you don't, and we can discuss it, of course. I usually answer every and single one of your comments, so you know already that I'm available to help anyone that needs some help or to ask me something. Or you can also join the Telegram group that we have. We have a new Telegram group since a week ago, and you can join it by opening your browser and writing t.me/fumoney, and it will take you directly to this page where you can join the group. Or you can open Telegram and search on the search box for fumoney, and it will take you there, so you know already. Sorry, you know already the icons that you have to see to join the group. So again, guys, gently touch the like button if you enjoy the content, subscribe to the channel if you are new, and share it with your friends, of course. I hope to see you again tomorrow on the next one. Bye-bye.